Hey guys, AJ here, and today we'll talk about what you can do to make grinding at Midsummer Courtyard 6 easier for you, even with DPS units that aren't optimal for this stage. You unlock this domain at AR45, and this is where you grind out your Thunder Soother and Thundering Fury sets. As of this recording, this is the highest and most difficult level for this domain and guarantees you at least one 5-star artifact per run, so it's definitely worth getting to the point where you can reliably clear this one by yourself, because chances are you'll spend a lot of time in here. Again, I recommend you save up all of your fragile resin refills for this AR45 plus grind, and if you're not AR45 yet and are struggling with Midsummer Courtyard 5, you'll find the link to a video on that one in the description. Similar to Midsummer Courtyard 5, you're still being punished for using Electro and Cryo and rewarded for using Pyro. So if you have a built Pyro unit, you'll have a much easier time grinding here. Xiangling and especially Amber are again the best units for you to bring as supports. The fourth slot is flexible. For free-to-play options, I recommend Noelle for her shields and Barbara for her ultimate heal, but don't use her E because that will do you more harm than good. If you have Bennett, I would use him over Barbara for his healing and attack buff and the fact that he's Pyro. I myself use Xingqiu. Not only does he give a bit of healing, he also makes it so that I take less damage from enemy hits while his swords are up, and he provides some extra damage on the side. Before we go in, let's have a quick look at our gear. Ironically, Thunder Soother is the very best set to have for clearing this domain. Everything in here deals electro damage to you, meaning that the electro resistance bonus is exactly what you want. The 4-piece set bonus is perfect as well, since you're getting a 35% damage bonus against enemies afflicted with electro. Since you're fighting electro slimes in wave 1 that are permanently electrified, you have great uptime on this bonus damage without having to do anything. Against the magicians in wave 2 though, you will have to apply electro yourself. Even your supports can make good use of this set, especially the 2-piece bonus for extra survivability. One more thing you could do in terms of gear is equip a physical damage percent goblet on your main DPS unit, since we'll be using physical, normal, and charged attacks for the majority of our damage output. Once you start the challenge, you'll first have to deal with 3 purple and 2 yellow electro slimes. The 2 yellow slimes will stay in the back, while the purple slimes will try to swarm you. The problem here is that it's quite difficult to just brute force your way through them, because they keep zapping you, which constantly interrupts your attacks. The best way to deal with these slimes is to try and isolate them. With Keqing, you can send one of them flying with your charged attack, run after them, and repeat the process until you're out of stamina. That way you gain at least a few seconds in which the other slimes don't bother you. With any other carry, you'll rely more on your support units. What you can do is divert some attention with Amber's Taunt Bunny, cause overload explosions with Xiangling's Guoba, or any other pyro skills you have to send some of them flying while you work on another slime, or pop Xiangling's Q. This ability is very powerful in here because it practically disables these slimes for the entirety of its duration, giving you a couple of seconds to deal free damage without any retaliation. Once you get the first slime down, the others become much easier. Sadly, there aren't any easy cheese strats like with Midsummer Courtyard 5, but the basic concept is don't let them surround you, try to split them up. If you're into geo characters, you could probably try some fancy stuff like blocking them with geo constructs, but if not, overload is your best friend. Kiting this stage with pyro abilities sadly isn't very efficient, because the domain's electro debuff drains your energy over time. In wave 2, you'll have to fight 2 of these electro magicians. It's quite hard to group them up as they keep teleporting around, so I recommend you kill one first and then go for the remaining one. If you're wearing Thunder Soother, your first objective is to apply Electro and then start dealing physical damage. I would not use any pyro skills at this point, because those will just consume the Electro status that you just applied. These mages shoot a lot of stuff at you, so try to conserve your stamina as much as possible by doing normal attacks. Don't stand in lightning, don't stand in the barrier, and always wait with crucial skills until right after their teleport. Otherwise, chances are they'll just dodge. At some point during the fight, they'll start channeling what I just call their ultimate skill, where they cast an electro barrier and zap the hell out of you if you get too close to them after they're done charging up. Even if they're behind you and you can't see them as they start channeling, it's also clearly audible and sounds something like this. Yeah. Luckily for us, there's a very simple workaround to this incoming catastrophe, and that's... make sure to position the bunny directly between you and the magicians for them to get taunted. After that, you can just pop their shields with overloads by hitting them with one or two charged pyro shots, and then go back into close combat. I hope this mini guide somewhat helped you. If you have any questions, as always, let me know, and thank you so much for watching.